On the heels of the crucial Moscow format talks on Afghanistan, Pakistan's Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi has met the Taliban's acting Prime Minister Mullah Hassan Akhund and the Deputy Prime Minister Abdul Salam Hanafi for bilateral talks. He was welcomed earlier by Afghanistan's acting Foreign Minister Amir Khan Muttaqi at the Kabul International Airport. The day-long visit was set to be brief and agenda-specific. The delegation included the head of the ISI, the country's intelligence agency, Faiz Hamid, as well. In a bid to deepen cooperation, the two sides focused on several issues. The visit comes after long-standing problems at the Chaman border crossing. The crossing has been closed for more than 2 weeks now, causing trouble for scores of truckers and exporters. The meeting focused on the opening of the border crossing points under COVID-19 protocols. The Foreign Office said Pakistan has constantly provided humanitarian aid to the Afghan people. The visit also looked at strengthening economic ties.
This moment, Afghan people are facing great difficulties because of the change that has taken place in Afghanistan. There are humanitarian challenges, there are economic challenges, there are political challenges, and Pakistan, as a brotherly neighboring country, is trying to assist Afghanistan in this process. Foreign minister's visit is a positive message to reinforce Pakistan's message for lasting peace and stability in Afghanistan, and this is the objective of this visit.
Now, this is not the first time that Pakistani officials have visited Kabul, of course. Remember, Pakistan's ISI chief, Lieutenant General Faiz Hamid, had earlier visited Kabul and met with the Taliban leaders. This was when the Taliban interim government was yet to be announced. This visit comes just as 10 countries, including India, China, Pakistan and other Central Asian partners, participated in the Moscow format talks. And with us on the broadcast is our correspondent Anas Malik from Kabul. Anas, what can you tell us about the engagements and who all were present?
Well, Molly, a significant visit. Pakistani foreign minister becomes the third foreign minister to visit Afghanistan. And with him, since the fall of Kabul, and with him was a huge delegation. In his delegation from the Pakistani side were the Pakistani DG ISI Lieutenant General Faiz Hamid, the Pakistani Foreign Secretary Sohail Mehmood, the Secretary of Commerce, Saleh Farooqi, Chairman Pakistan International Airlines, the Chairman PIA Arshad Malik. We had the Chairman Database Registration Authority, Chairman Nadra as well, people from the customs, people from Pakistani Federal Board of Revenue, the FBR, and so on. And they had a lot of engagement. They had meetings with their counterparts. There was there were supposed to be 4 meetings during this trip, but due to the paucity of time, the first meeting was the only meeting that took place, and that lasted for about 3.5 hours. That we did see that there were smaller meetings within that meeting that were being held by the groups that were there, but by large, only one meeting, if I talk to you, that took place, that was under the leadership or under the chairpersonship of the Afghan deputy, Afghan interim prime minister Mullah Hassan Akhund. And whereas in participation on the Afghan side was the Afghan interior minister Sirajuddin Haqqani, the Afghan defense minister Mullah Yaqub, right. Then we had the Afghan deputy prime minister Abdul Salam Hanafi and others. What was very interesting was that Mullah Abdul Ghani brother was missing from today's gathering. It is still unclear why was he missing. Is he in Kandahar? Is he not in the country? But the fact that such a significant visit was taking place and Mullah Abdul Ghani brother was not there. Molly?
Right. Adding to the significance of the visit is that Qureshi is the third foreign minister to visit Kabul under the Taliban and was accompanied by the ISI chief as well.
Well, yes, the Pakistani Foreign Minister Qureshi, Shah Mahmood Qureshi, becomes the third foreign minister to visit, but he comes with a huge delegation, a more meaningful delegation that has the Pakistani DG ISI, Lieutenant General Faiz Hamid as well, and talks focused on different areas of key cooperation that included border management, return of refugees, educational scholarships, economic crisis. The Pakistani Foreign Minister, while speaking to me, he said that a delegation of the Taliban would soon be traveling, though that comes with the caveat because Pakistan is yet to formally recognize. There are talks that were broadened up. As I said, I was there. I was inside the Afghan presidential palace as well, and I saw things very, very closely. What needs to be seen is that will these talks transpire into actions on ground, because Pakistan's fear that bigger apprehension of the Tehreek-e-Taliban, Pakistan TTP, using Afghan soil to attack, to launch attacks from Afghanistan into Pakistan, that has to be addressed. That was one of the key focus or one of the key agendas of today's visit as well. And what we understand is that there are assurances that are given, but would these assurances transpire into actions on ground or not? That remains to be seen. Molly?
Anas Malik getting us those details from Kabul. We are leaving it there for the moment. Thanks very much.